Welcome to the Tech Tuesday session by Cloud SE. Myself Vadivelu and I work here as a software developer. In this session, we are going to see something about VM migrations and the common issues we'll be facing when we do a VM migration. So VM migration, what do you mean by that? So just by a click, migrate all the VMs in your local machine or in your local environment to Azure, just by a click, using the platform provided by Cloud SE called Hyper. So what are all the famous or the common problems which we face during a VM migration are like, do we need to like pre-process the VM before even like migrating to Azure, and what are those things, and what are the inputs what Azure accepts and not like create a VM, and what are the number of disks, and how we do subnetting there and NSG there, etc., and how are we going to handle VMs with checkpoints, and what is the space complexity, and how are we going to handle the failure rates and retry logics for pre-processing VHDs, and how are we going to copy those VHDs from local environment to Azure. So these are the basic five difficulties we are going to discuss today. So coming back to the first one, is there any pre-processing setup needed for like migrating on a VM to Azure? Yes, we do have like some common steps which has to be done on a VM before even we can migrate to Azure, something like enabling the RDPs and like clearing off the private network settings and those things. So we have an abstract step for all the users to like pass through where we like process this VM so that it can be migrated to Azure. So next comes this input provided to Azure. So the basic inputs which we provide to Azure is nothing but an VHD file, and Azure has this constraint like it should be of fixed type and it should be of type VHD, and it doesn't even accept any VHDX or like dynamic VHD. So we should pre-process all that, and number of disks depend upon the subscription which we avail. Let's say we avail a standard, so we'll be like provided something with two data disks, something like that. And then subnetting in NSG, we do have capabilities to handle all the subnetting and network security things also. And coming to the how we handle checkpoints and space complexities. So in production environment, there cannot be any constraint of like having any number of checkpoints. So a VM can have any number of checkpoints, and each checkpoint can be also like 10 GB size also. So our logic is capable of like copying all these checkpoints, bringing to an environment where the VM is not even disturbed, and merging it and then uploading to the Azure. And space complexity, the customer need not worry about the space because we are not doing anything on this machine. So it will be like completely an isolated environment where all the steps will be handled. And failure rates and retry logics, yes, when we are handling with a huge amount of data, failures are about like sort to happen. So we have some retry logics which can like detect are the errors retryable and retry after specified number of times and specified duration. So how we copy VHDs to Azure and handle failures in the same? We use this Azure copy, a product of Azure itself, where it handles failures in a very seamless way. And if anything fails, even the copies can start from a part where it actually failed. Let's say like the copy failed in a 50%, it can actually resume its copy from 51st%. So that's how we deal with it. So these are the basic things we deal with. Any doubts, don't hesitate to like contact us. Thank you.